today we're working with bay mussels like this one. We collected these ones about a month ago in the bay right here. And what we've done is we exposed them in these mesocosms for a month to varying degrees of CO2.
For animals with shells, the oceans are typically a great place to live. From corals to clams, these animals play critical roles in the ecosystem as filter feeders, food for other creatures, and habitat creators. Most of the time, their shell house building material can be pulled right out of the ocean that surrounds them. But as the ocean absorbs extra carbon dioxide humans are pumping into the atmosphere, the waters become more acidic, and that can make building material for a strong protective shell hard to come by.
My name is Iria Jimenez. We are right now at the Marna Wet Lab, which is a state-of-the-art experimental laboratory at the Quadra Island Field Station. We can do a whole amount of different experiments in here, but it's particularly set up to explore the effects of ocean acidification in a wide variety of organisms. We already know that the mussels are vulnerable to ocean acidification, particularly that early life stage, the larvae. But what we don't know so well, and there's been multiple studies around the world that have shown conflicted results, is how do the larvae do when the parents have already experienced high CO2 while they were getting ready to produce the sperm and the eggs. We've exposed them for a month in these tanks to different amounts of CO2, so we are basically encouraging them to release their sperm and their eggs, and we're collecting those and manually mix them so we can fertilize those eggs so we can produce larvae. And starting today, we are gonna also do the same with the larvae, with their offspring. Then 2-3 weeks from now, when the larvae are ready to go to the next life stage, we'll see how they fare. And if actually exposing their parents helped them, gave them some sort of resiliency, or the opposite, if exposing the parents and stressing them out already had a negative effect on their larvae.
The results of this research will help scientists and shellfish farmers better understand how mussels and their relatives fare in our changing oceans.